our master, our masters, our teachers, parents, students, and friends of the RTDBS community. As the co-teacher and teacher representative, I'm honored to speak to all of you. I am a teacher of students, therefore I am a teacher. This title, teacher, is deceiving. Who is teaching whom? I will not be a teacher without students. Students will not be students without teachers, without tutors, without mentors. It is said that there are 84,000 ways for doors to awakening. Why? It's because of the interactions between one teacher and the rest of the 84,000 totally different individuals. Being a teacher comes with uncomfortable factors. For example, the relationships between teacher and student, between student and students, between student and siblings, and the relationship between parent and student. Then there are emotions and moods of different degrees. Multiply each mood to days, weeks, months, and years. A teacher is faced with all these combinations of factors, like working with jigsaw puzzles. When everything fits, when all go well, what you get is, voila, a perfectly matched dazzling image. Of course, in reality, life is not that way. So a teacher tries to come up with a different strategy. Recently, one teacher nun graduated from the Thammara Buddhist University, and students found out that their teacher would be going away to a branch temple. One student wondered, when we graduate, we find a job. What do nuns do after graduation, since they don't work? Yeah, I thought about it. That's a good question. After a moment of contemplating, I replied to her, after graduation, nuns share the knowledge with others. Every experience changes a person, and we are changed by every experience. How can we, as living human beings, stay the same by our methods of knowledge and experience? Thank you for the question, Christina. Teaching involves developing wisdom for both students and teachers. We help each other, and we are helped by each other. During this past semester, I taught Sanskrit as part of Buddhism class. Sanskrit is a language that is not taught at many universities. Learning the script as the first step is an obstacle that Sanskrit students have to overcome. When I introduced the script, one student said, she learned the script from an Indian neighbor when she was young. She still remembered how to write her name in Devanagari script. It was a delight for me to hear this anecdote. Something was planted in her consciousness. Whatever you take into your awareness will stay in that store of consciousness. Invest wisely in that bank of awareness in order to benefit yourself and others. Class of 2019, I want to acknowledge that this year, with your leadership and cooperation, you helped make the WASP visit to our school a success. The same goes to the parents, teachers, and the CTDB community of volunteers and different departments. And of course, due to the wisdom and compassion of Venerable Master Hua, the developing virtue secondary school has arrived this far. With parents and teachers working together, our school will continue to sustain and thrive on, producing wholesome citizens who will benefit the world. Here is a trivia question for everyone. What is something that this school requires every student to do but it doesn't appear on foreign transcripts. The answer is memorization of standards for students. It has been a great privilege for me to listen to my students memorize verses from this text. I think the standards for students might as well be called the standards for teachers. I have chosen two inspirational verses from the last chapter of this text that I find appropriate for this occasion, for the class of 2019. When you've taken a study of something, don't let yourself become sidetracked. Be sure that you finish one project before starting off on another. Let your goals be lofty and broad. Let your efforts be focused and steady. Once you have skill and experience, you will solve every problem with ease. Class of 2019, take these two advices to make your dream come true. Congratulations.